What's going on, everybody? David here. Just want to do a quick video. I saw that there was a leak of the PDF for the Canon EOS R, and I wrote down a few things. A few things that I'm a little disappointed with, but I'll go ahead and mention those. And I'm hoping maybe some of this stuff isn't true, but the PDF's out there. I'll post a link in the description so you guys can check the PDF out. The first thing is no IBIS, so no image stabilization in body, which is that's pretty disappointing. I was hoping that they would incorporate that. That way I can use any lens and still have that lens stabilized. But in this situation, it's not going to happen. There's no mention of 4K crop. So we'll just have to wait till September 5th when they release to find out if it will be a crop of 4K. 1080p at 60 frames per second instead of 120 frames per second, which is a little disappointing. I mainly want to use this camera for video. And when I travel, and I like to do the super slow-mo every once in a while, but I guess that's not going to be an option with this camera. Autofocus points. This is really interesting. 5,655 autofocus points. So we'll have to see when they roll it out how that works, because that's going to be interesting there. No eye autofocus. I thought that was really strange. The M50 has eye autofocus, but this camera is not going to have eye autofocus. It looks like there's only going to be one card slot. That's not a deal breaker for me. I mainly want to use it just for travel. So it's one of those deals where I take pictures and I back them up constantly. So it's not going to be a big deal. If I was shooting weddings with it or something like that, then yeah, that would be more of an issue. I think when they roll out their next camera, it's probably going to be, they'll probably have dual card slots and they'll be more targeted towards the professional. Now, saying that, I don't know what the price point is yet. I'm hoping the price point is under $2,000. If that's the case, then I think the camera will still be a really, really great camera. So we'll just have to wait and see what happens, what comes out. But more importantly, though, I'd like to know what you guys think, so please post in the comments below. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe for more, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye.